What's the most NSFW thing to happen within your workplace? Some teenagers were exchanging oral in a theater when people told us our cop went and got them and called the parents. Then the cop had to mind sucking a D for the mom of the girl because she didn't speak English. Best security tape footage ever. I once walked in on a grad student boiling a big beaker of ammonia without a fume hood. Stay at home dad here. I ducked my wife at my workplace one time. Half the company has ducked in the office at some point. Mostly with each other. Some highlights. The owner was having an affair with an hour person. She threatened to expose him. Unless he was a silent partner in a business she wanted to start. My cubicle mate's wife came to visit and they banged out in her car. We could see from a meeting room. A crowd gathered, coffee mugs in hand. At the last Christmas party I was getting a blowjob from a friend with benefits in the hallway. I accidentally yanked on the fire alarm. Drunk. As I finished and she still had cum in her mouth as people were running to the door. The boss wrote a poem about his D and read it to employees. Posted this before but this is my story. I work in a nightclub in a European capital. Since I used to be a paramedic, all the bouncers and hostesses will approach me as soon as there is some blood or whatever gross thing a human body can produce is involved. So one night the bouncers came to me at the bar and were like, "Dude, you're a paramedic, right? And you speak English?" I told them yes, I was. And yes I did. They went like, "Could you just follow us for a minute?" I went with them and they took me to the secret ladies' bathroom. For VIPs only. At the door. They told me, "Just go in there and try your best." Me. Not expecting anything weird at all. Went in. What I saw was a butt naked Australian chick who was as high as a kite. She was sitting on the toilet. Holding an actual turd in her hand. Pretending it was a cigarette. Her whole mouth looked. I don't even wanna think about that. So I was like, "WTF are you doing?" And she took the turd out of her mouth. Looked at it. Looked at me and was like, "Oh. No worries. It's not mine." The entire staff of a Sonic drive-in I worked at got drunk one time. I was caught on camera mixing drinks for other employees and rolling a joint on the prep table. I knew I was totally ducked so I said I organized the whole thing. Brought all the liquor and whatnot. So no one else would get it canned. Company was nice enough to not call the police. So that was swell. Lady tried to kill herself. She'd come in earlier than usual and cut her wrists at her desk. Since her cube was in one of those weird you deliberately have to turn the corner to see if she's even in their kind of spots. People were in the office and milling about before anybody discovered her. Very surreal scene as half the floor knew what was happening and in a panic. While the other half had no idea what was going on. So you hear a scream. And then you see somebody run out the door crying. And you start to try to put together the story about how our manager yelled at one of the girls and she got upset. Then somebody comes flying into the kitchen looking for paper towels and you think, "Oh, okay, somebody spilled something." Then somebody yelled. Somebody took it the wrong way and started crying. And you really have no concept of what it could have actually been. Until somebody tells you. She did survive, though. So at least there's a happy ending to the story. It. Okay. Maybe happy ending is not the right phrase. I just didn't want people to come away from the story thinking that she'd died. She did get help and from what I understand has been doing just fine. A few years ago I worked at a company where they caught an intern masturbating in his cubicle. He wasn't fired. Because he was actually good at what he did in his position. But the story spread out and from that moment on. He was called Fappy. Even by every boss in the company. A few times when I was working overseas, a rival company started launching explosive rockets at us. To make it even weirder, their CEO came into our compound after one of these events and demanded payment from us to make it stop. Our job was to provide free electricity and infrastructure development in said country. And our boss decided that was sufficient payment to avoid explosive rocket deliveries. I should stop working for the government. I worked at a pizza place and the owner, a mildly overweight Greek dude in his 40s, lived upstairs and would occasionally drunkenly come stumbling down to the kitchen in his underwear, tighty whities, and tell us to cook him up a rack of ribs. The kitchen was visible from the dining room. Had six in the walk-in freezer. Finish and pulled out. Cum drips onto the freezer floor and freezes to the floor. I grab the Nothal floor cleaner. One clean spot on the dirty freezer floor looks suspicious as duck. So I clean the whole freezer. I'm almost done and boss walks in. Gives me a pat on the back for cleaning it without being told. I drove the forklift. Without certification. At a restaurant I used to work at, two customers were caught ducking in the bathroom. When the manager told them to leave, they asked if they could at least finish. The manager was like, "Duck no. Now get the duck out." I honestly don't get the appeal of ducking in a public restroom. That's just disgusting to me. One girl that I used to work with did anal in the bathroom with a guy that also worked with us. Months later, that same girl did anal with a second, different guy we used to work with. At a retail job, we had no customer bathroom. So this lady kept trying to enter break room when employee would walk in and out, and when that failed she pulled her skirt up and took a piss on the floor. There was a Starbucks next door to us. They don't care if you're a customer or not, they let everyone use their bathroom. People banged in the freezer at Subway for years. Several Subways. This happened in the 80s and I was still in elementary school. But it's a bit of a legend here. So we make a piece of equipment that has relay switches, and a client called in to talk to tech support about a problem he was having. Our tech on the phone wanted to determine whether the relays were working properly or not. So he asked the client to perform a procedure to make the relays switch. Unfortunately, the client had not disconnected the equipment or done anything to ensure it was safe to do so. And our technician didn't ask. So the relays were working and they switched. This caused a large diverter gate dart, basically a massive steel plate, to move. And there just happened to be another person working in there at the time. The plate moved and crushed the guy. All hell broke loose over the phone and the guy hung up on our tech. We later found out what happened when we were included in the workers' comp lawsuits. We ended up not having to pay out, since it's the responsibility of the local guy to ensure the equipment is locked out before doing work. But we have a policy with all our techs now about confirming with the client that the equipment is safe to be worked on before we start assisting with troubleshooting. I visited a customer once where the safety sign showing how long it had been since their last injury said 3 days since our last work-related death. That guy had been electrocuted because he didn't lock out the equipment he was working on. Somebody turned on the juice from about a mile away and fried him. TLDR. Lockout tag out. Rather than find a taller ladder, someone tried to climb a ladder that was raised by a forklift. I used to be a store manager at Sneaker Sporting Goods store in the mall. One of my co-managers was ducking one of my teenage, underage, employees in the back stock room after the store closed on a regular basis. This was going on for several months apparently. I found out when said teenager came to me and she said that my co-manager promised her a raise that she never got. I asked her why he said that he would give her a raise. That is when she told me about Fessix in the stock room. I had to call the police and corporate about this. We arranged a sting with help of the girl, as she acted out for the police that to meet up with my co-manager after work. Basically caught him with his pants down, to use the term. I used to work a retail job in college. In the back areas, stock rooms, bathrooms, a lot of stuff went down. I met an ex-girlfriend via that job, and needless to say, areas inaccessible to customers were used in ways that were not intended. Customer pulled his pants down to show us the rash he got from his hot tub on his genitals. We come into work on Monday morning and there are post-it notes in random spots on horizontal surface through the office. Turns out one of the guys we work with ducked his girlfriend in the office, and she thought it'd be cute to put the post-it notes everywhere they had been. One guy flipped his forklift onto some railroad tracks outside the building. That was rather not safe for work. Using the other definition of NSFW, one of the robot prototypes once crashed, as it did rather often. But when the manufacturer's technicians logged in remotely from abroad, they noticed that the main terminal had several tabs of Pornhub open in the background, clogging up the system. Another machine once began smoking while I was working on it, and while troubleshooting I discovered that the source of the smoke was a half-melted condom entangled under a drive belt. Not sure I want to know why. I accidentally linked my development team to our objects once. Everyone laughed it off and I still have my job. Ordered a couple SSD and a handful of memory kits for laptops from Amazon. Received 3 boxes. First box, memory. Second box, memory. Third box, strap-on friendly. Purple, dildo. Thanks Amazon. Our accountant came by and mentioned he has some issues with a website he set up for his photography. He said he couldn't access it at all from home or log into the server or anything at all. We enter his page and get bombarded with pornos, pop-up ads for the extensions and all that jazz. Marines. We got shot at. But oddly, it's kinda safe for work, without being safe at all. Two male employees were caught having an L6 inside a safety shower in the clean room manufacturing facility. A female co-worker pulled down her pants just a bit, reached inside and pulled out a bag of weed that she was keeping near her crotch and offered to roll me a joint. After work, the few people in the company I work for went for some beer. It relatively quickly escalated to whiskey and vodka. At about 8, everybody was totally drunk. Because I live 45 minutes away from work, and so I went with the only female co-worker to sleep in the office. Well, things got sexual there. The next morning we were on the couch near the entrance, spooning and still asleep. This is something nobody ever talked about after it happened. We both almost lost our job though, because the boss wasn't very amused. Boss walked into the back storage to find a server chugging box cooking wine. Definitely a tie between one of my co-workers having a seizure and me crapping my pants twice at work in the same night. My wife and I, was my girlfriend at the time of course, had sex in the kitchen of the local pizza place where we worked. Was pretty fun. And hey, if you leave 16-year-olds alone in a pizza kitchen and business is slow, what do you think's going to happen? Equals P. Wearing headphones. Took a piss and somehow they looped around my D and I didn't notice. Talking to my manager. She tells me I'm not allowed to wear headphones. I go to pull them out of my shirt. Oops, theresmatic JPG. Well, yesterday the fat slob I work with got sick and it himself. He was waddling towards the elevator saying he had to go home. He didn't even clock out. The chair had yellow stains on it. I split my head open on the compactor door once at work. After the bleeding slowed down a bit, I had my girlfriend drive me to the med stop. Had to get staples. A guy was cleaning out a Banbury mixer for rubber with alcohol and an uncaged drop light. The light fell, ignited the alcohol, and he had to crawl through the fire to get out. When the paramedics showed up to take him away, they had difficulty telling what was his uniform and what was his skin. I work in a hospital that has both a somatic and a psychiatric department. One of the psychiatric patients was released a little too early and found her way to the somatic part, where she smashed a lamp in a toilet. Went to the main entrance, there's a big waiting area, so lots of people, and stabbed herself repeatedly in the neck. She was saved by an employee of mine, who was in the area by chance. She reacted instinctively and saved her life. The patient was in the OR in a couple of hours. Back to the psych dep, who released her the next day, where she promptly repeated her suicide attempt. She's back in the psych dep now, and I don't think they're gonna release her soon. Husband and wife truck driving team. At a cooler for a pickup. Husband delayed while getting paperwork completed. Wife goes to check his status. There are painted lines everywhere telling you where it is safe to walk. She wasn't paying attention or waking in a safe area. Loaded forklift was loading cargo into another semi. She was pushed in. Forklift driver didn't see or hear or feel a thing. She was crushed but alive in between pallets of product and died on the way to the next location. Husband couldn't find her. They spent hours looking for her. He left, and several states away they found her body when the truck WSS unloaded. Not sure why he left. Don't mess around in warehouses. I work in the emergency department as a nurse. We had a belligerent young man come in, very agitated, confused and aggressive with staff while masturbating. We ended up restraining him. After many hours and every test coming back negative, he seemed to calm down and was acting somewhat normal. We took the restraints off and he ran to the sink. He proceeded to clog the sink with paper towel, filled the sink with water and then ejaculated into the sink water. Then he used his hands to scoop the sperm water into his mouth. He drank it all. Then ran out of the exit. At one of my previous jobs, it was said that during one of the Christmas parties, a couple decided to bang on the CEO's desk. He walked in, saw them, turned around, and instructed the office manager to tell them to turn off the lights when they were done. The music industry is an interesting place. My boss ducks his secretary in the office. His secretary is his wife and the office is his home. Not me, but a friend. Also, I get to visit the plant today anyway. My buddy works at a plant that turns old magazines and books into a binding agent. So in the end, the paper get cut into shreds and is mixed with concrete. The majority of the magazines are porn magazines, and he said that there is porn posted around the plant. For $75 they can get 1 ton of the recycled paper. The other day he told me he found an old book worth $50. He's gonna sell it on eBay. You can thank your pornos for recycling. A guest at a wedding was stabbed repeatedly by her ex-husband, who showed up during the after-dinner party. He broke a beer bottle and maimed her chest. Chunks of her breasts were hanging off. She was mostly in shock, but there was blood everywhere. We ended up using our stash of aprons to stop the bleeding. Never a dull day in the hotel business. Girl in my lab was wearing flip-flops, shorts, and walking around with a beaker full of an unlabeled liquid without gloves on. One of our nurses ducked one of our paranoid schizophrenic service users. We are an outpatient unit, but he is a vulnerable individual nonetheless. Happened before I started here. I work at a fake college, 16-18 year olds mainly. One of the women in my department was regularly blowing one of the builders who were building a new building for us. She got caught. Didn't even get fired. I worked as a lifeguard at a pool, with all of my friends from the neighborhood including the manager. We would sneak in at night, drink duck, have parties in the pool. On one of our busiest days, one guard who wasn't working threw a big old turd in the pool so we could all go home and day drink. I miss that job. I work at a self-serve frozen yogurt place. While closing the front one night, I went to clean the bathroom and found that someone had jerked off and jizzed all over our toilet. Not cool, man. When I was a teenager, I banged a girl in the bathroom at the restaurant we worked at, and fingered her in the freezer. Now that think about it, I worked for a bank, and a mid-manager had his desk kit on. Twice, a temp had his toe run over by a cherry picker forklift with no steel-toed boots. It smooshed the inside of his big toe out to the outside of his big toe. Boss brought in a picture of himself with a stripper and showed it to everyone. He was rather proud of himself.